Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome from Destiny Church in Weston Supermare. I was trying to combine Weston and Destiny, so it's worth a try, wasn't it? Anyway, welcome. This is Destiny Church based in Weston Supermare in the UK. Great to have you with us this morning. Please join in if you want to connect with us. We've got a website, destinyuk.com, and if you send an email to welcome@destinyuk.com, we'll send you details of how you can connect. So good to have you with us this morning.
Yes,
your tulips are nearly coming out, aren't they?
Yeah, so, next week. Signs of amazing.
Spring and some iris behind you.
Yes,
I mean. Yeah, oh, we must. Oh, oh, it's a bit romantic, isn't it?
Yeah, it's one of my favourite flowers.
Yeah, I know you like it. You like that colour, don't you?
Yeah,
very good. So, welcome all around the world. It's great to join. We know that people view us all the way across the UK and across the world. So it's good to have worldwide viewers.
Across the world.
Yes.
If I said to people, do you remember a song called Convoy GB, Rubber Duck 10-4?
I know where you're going with this.
What would that bring to mind?
CB radio. And what's your husband just done? He's just got his amateur radio license, hasn't he?
Yeah.
And he was talking to someone in the Philippines yesterday, would you believe? And Hawaii. So all across the world, just like this morning.
See? There's no escaping us.
Great. We're moving on to a new message this week called Reckless Love. But we're just going to take a recap at Anchored, number 3 in Anchored, aren't we, as well?
Yeah.
So my takeaways from there were sometimes we tend to play around a bit in the shadows, don't we? Or even the shallows sometimes.
Shadows and the shallows.
When we need to be out in the deep. So we need to make sure that we're where God wants us to be. And also when we've been toiling all night, we can keep trusting all day. So we can. Because we've been toiling, we can keep that trust in God. And a great sentence that Pastor Mike came up with, which is, God is our rock, faith is our anchor, and hope is our anchor, and faith is our chain. Yeah, look at my notes. That was my takeaways. What's your takeaways?
Well, actually, just as you were saying about being out in the deep, I had a flash come through my mind when I was snorkeling out in the Caribbean, and I was way out my depth.
Yes, you were.
And I thought, I'm never, part of the reason I couldn't get onto the shore was there was coral and I didn't want to get ripped to pieces.
Yeah.
And I had a long swim, about half a mile through the waves, and I'm thinking, isn't that a bit not
yeah.
more than
you gave
I
me
do.
A fright there, you did. Yeah. What a global program we are this morning, aren't we? Eh?
But actually, going back to the thoughts that I took was that the first one was, it's no longer the weight of the challenge causing the problem, it's the weight. What's wrong with our teeth this morning? It's the weight of their breakthrough. That's something to be really excited about.
Yeah.
How often do we actually think about the weight of our breakthrough?
Absolutely.
And, in fact, one of the other things that I was thinking about is, when God gives his word, we have to be ready for his blessing. So we should be thinking about it and preparing about it.
Yeah, getting ready for blessings.
Barney said in his about practicing to receive the blessings of God. And I thought, how often do we do that?
Yeah, that's all right. No, that was a great, great divert, wasn't he? Picked up on that weight of the breakthrough, given a new challenge. Yeah, go on.
And the other thing was that we don't just need the faith to believe, we need the faith to receive.
Yes.
And it made me think of, a lot of people say, we don't do it, but a lot of people say, if only I won the lottery or whatever, all my problems would be solved. But you find that 9 times out of 10, the majority of lottery winners can't handle that money. And I was also reminded of a sermon I heard years ago about, what's your choke point? How much blessing are we prepared to receive from God? Because, we all like to be blessed and we can cope with a little bit. But if it keeps coming and keeps coming, we're just not used to it. But I'm open for it. So, Lord, practice with me.
I think that was really good. And I think Barney picked up that well in the Devo, didn't he? Just let's not restrict the size of that blessing. Let's
Absolutely.
Be open. That's what you're saying, isn't it? Let's just, thank you, Lord. Yeah.
And work on removing the hindrances.
Yeah.
You know, because, yeah.
And we're not just talking about material blessings, are we?
No,
all sorts
absolutely.
Of blessings. Blessings of family and relationships and everything. Yeah. Circumstances.
Health.
Yeah, health, healing. Whoa, so much. Yeah, so.
Yeah, we could keep God busy for a while. So many areas, Lord.
Just a reminder, we are from Destiny Church in Weston-super-Mare in the UK. And if you want to connect, please send an email to welcome@destinyuk.com. Now, we're moving on this week from anchored to reckless love. And wow. You want to know how Pastor Mike has got from between those two. There's a bridge between those two. And I feel like I've been given a special revelation. This
oh,
is,
dear.
Yeah, brace yourself. This is profound. How we go from anchored to reckless love. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you're anchored, your boat is safe. In other words, it's not a wreck. Okay. So you could be said to be reckless. Are you with me? Keep there. And that means if you are reckless, you can practice reckless love.
It's amazing how your brain works.
I think that was one. I'm getting a clap from the control room here. I think that was one of the ones that Pastor Mike would say. Turn to the other camera. I'll say that again. I think he would, because it was so profound in its revelation there. So anyway, moving swiftly on. We've had some people joining us. So welcome to photographs we've had. We've had photographs, yeah. Penny and Zach, and big picture Kane in the picture there.
Faith. Mia and Mike.
Yeah, Mia and Mike. Faith was there. Toby was there. There's a picture Helen.
Yeah.
Yeah, so people joining us. Do join us on the Facebook.
Sadie and Sean.
Yeah, join us on the Facebook stream as well. Put your comments in there all the way through. And please be kind. When it gets to 11:50, people will be joining us because they didn't change their clocks. So please just... Be kind in the comments if someone pops up at 11:50. Yeah, the clocks have changed today, haven't they?
They have.
Yeah, or yesterday. Yeah, that's right.
I know. We're all just bright-eyed and bushy-tailed.
Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed.
An extra espresso.
So this is the week we're leading up to Easter, and just to say that on Friday. We have a communion for Good Friday, so that's going to be 11 a.m. So make sure that you tune in to Facebook at 11 a.m. And we'll have a live stream or a stream there from, of communion. So make sure you join us. Then. We're going to be leading that, and the pastor's going to be providing some worship and praise as well. So we're looking forward to that, aren't we?
Yeah. And don't forget to share.
Yeah, remember to share.
Yeah. Not just today, but especially on Friday as well.
Yes.
And throughout the week as the various videos and
things
come on.
I think that is a good point, isn't it? Yeah, that you know, you do have to kind of sometimes go out your way on Facebook to find the things. Yeah. So, you know, there's always this Devo every week. So make sure you search out that Devo as well as other material that comes through the week. There's a recap of different things. So
There's no escaping.
No escape. Do remember, if you want us to pray for you afterwards, send an email to prayer@destinyuk.com as well. So we're looking forward to a great morning of reckless
love.
You won't be able to see that in the same way, will you? Good to have you with us. So what do we need to have ready?
Pencils.
What do we need to do?
Get our praise pants on.
Can I have my stylus?
Yes, good.
Good, okay. And what's the other thing we need to do? Share.
Share.
So good to have you with us this morning for the 10 to 50.
Yeah.
Great.
Let's have a great week.
Great time. Great time this morning. See you soon.
Still you give yourself away. All the overwhelming changing is the climate, the splashes of your lightning. So I run into the downpour of your perfect love. I run to you. I'm holding on, I won't let go. So let your rain come and fall on me.
God has in store for us this morning. But you know, Palm Sunday was all about celebration. It was all about the expectation and the electric atmosphere that was in that place at that time as Jesus came on the donkey into Jerusalem. There was surely a party on the streets that day. It is great to celebrate, isn't it? Isn't it great to lift up the name of Jesus? To focus on the one who is above all things. And you know, Holy Week was all about expectation. It was all about looking forward. It was all about hope. And I hope this morning that your hope is firmly planted and fixed in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And to know that you know that you know that God has the very best for you. And today, He just wants to shower love and grace and peace upon you. So this morning, church, be blessed.
May His favor be upon you and a thousand
going before you and behind you and beside you, all around you, moving in you. He's with you, he's with you, in the morning and the evening, in the coming and the calling. You believe in, you're rejoicing. He's for you, he's for you.
Got to love The Blessing. Such a powerful, hopeful, unifying song. It really is amazing. He is for us. He is for us. Let those words sink in. He is for us. Remember who He is. Like I shared in my Devo this week, He is the creator of the universe. That's who's for us. He is able to bless us in the most amazing of ways. He's able to bless us beyond anything we can think of. So let's hear it for God in the house today. Let's hear it for Jesus. Amen. Amen. He is for us. He is for us. Amen. Amen. So it's Palm Sunday. We're leading up to Easter. It's a great time to think about our relationship with God as we remind ourselves of just how amazing the sacrifice Jesus made was, and then just how earth-shattering His resurrection was. He is risen. Come on, there should be some whooping and hollering today. He is risen. Let's glorify God in the house. Hallelujah. He is risen. Amen. Amen. Let's think about our offering a moment. Are you giving? Are you tithing? Are you living in that generous lifestyle that we are called to live? Are you getting first things first in your finance? If not, now is the time. It's Palm Sunday. Jesus is arriving. He's arriving. Remember, God loves you. He's got your back. Finance is the only area in the Bible it says that we can test God. So please test him. See that he knows what he is doing. See that he has your back. And stop money holding you back from living that free life we have in the name of Jesus. Amen? Amen. So if you'd like to give today, scan the QR code below or hop over to destinyuk.com and click the link to give. And if you're thinking, I don't know what to do, I'm stuck. Reach out, send an email to prayer@destinyuk.com. That's prayer@destinyuk.com. And Paul and Liz will be back in touch. Paul and Liz are some of our most experienced leaders in the church. They will pray with you. They will listen to. They will help you through whatever the situation it is that you are facing in the most loving of ways. God wants to see you break through. He wants to see you free. He wants to see you free of the trap of money. Amen. And remember, as the sound of the blessing is resonating around us, he is for us. He is for us. He is for us. God, absolutely everything is all for you. We lift it all up to you this morning. It's all in your name. Thank you so much for that amazing sacrifice and that astounding resurrection. Amen. Amen. And now sit down. Let's get ready for a great life-changing message from the fabulous Pastor Mike. Amen.
Hi guys, and welcome to Virtual Church. It's so good to have you here this morning, and we hope you are being blessed by the experience. If this is the first time you're joining us here at Destiny, we would love to connect with you further. So if you email us at welcome@destinyuk.com, our team will get back to you and give you all the ways that you can connect with us. We love to do life together here at Destiny, so it would be great to get to know you better. If you've got kids or youth, don't forget, we've got weekly programs going ahead for the kids and regular programs for the youth. If you want more information, don't hesitate to get in contact with us and we can hook you up with all the details. And kids, don't forget, I am looking forward to seeing all of you in our Zoom call later at 12:30. I can't wait. If any of you want prayer, then please keep in contact with us. For anything at all, we believe that prayer changes things and we want to stand with you and believe for your breakthrough. You can email us at prayer@destinyuk.com and people will pray for you, or you can get together in a prayer room. We really know that this can change things, so don't miss out on that opportunity. And if you're part of Destiny, don't forget we've got our regular Connect groups going on throughout the week. It's just a great opportunity to get together, have some fun, reflect on the message, and be able to pray together. So I look forward to seeing you there. Have a great week, guys, and we will see you really soon.
Hi, everyone. I just wanted to let you all know about the great virtual experiences we've got coming up over Easter here at Destiny. On Good Friday, that's next Friday, the 2nd of April at 11, we'll be having a special Good Friday communion experience. And then on Easter Sunday, that's next Sunday, the 4th of April, we'll have our Easter experience at 11 o'clock as well. Plus, we've not forgotten about Destiny Kids. We'll be having Kids Church at 10:30 a.m. on both Good Friday and Easter Sunday. It'll be great to see all the Destiny Kids in Fusion then. So we'll see you all online on Good Friday and Easter Sunday. Don't miss either of these great experiences.
God is our rock, hope is our anchor, faith is our chain. Our faith needs to be strong in order for our hope to be secure. We need to be totally out of our depth to truly value the tenacious strength of our anchor. Far too many believers play around in the shallow rather than venturing out into the deep. If you're experiencing a double challenge right now, you can expect a mighty miracle right next. God's word keeps us hopeful when everything's looking hopeless. When the challenge is out of your depth, the blessing will be beyond your comprehension. We don't just need the faith to believe, we need the grace to receive. A major breakthrough only requires one more minor move of faith. Well, good morning, Destiny. Good morning, DFAM. Good evening to our campus in the Philippines. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to whoever you are, wherever you're tuning in from. It's great to have you with us on this Palm Sunday. Would you let us know where you're tuning in from by either putting a comment in the comments section below on whatever social media feed you're on, or you can send an email to welcome@destinyuk.com and our team will get straight back to you, give you all the details about how you can stay up to date with what we're doing with our website and all our social media feeds. And it would just be great to connect with you. And it really encourages us to know who's tuning in and where they're tuning in from. We ask two things of people tuning in every single week. Two very simple things. The first one is to press the share button right now. Now, we know recently or sometime around about now, Facebook is removing the watch party option. So the only option you have to go for right now, it's so simple, is to press share. It won't cost you anything, but it could benefit other people hugely, because who knows who needs to hear this message today? And it may not even be that they will click into the content of this message today, but in the future, it could really speak into their situation. So I'd be so grateful if you could just press share right now, share it with your friends and your family and your work colleagues and whoever connects with you on social media. And the second thing is that we are an interactive church. We love to receive encouragement. We love to receive feedback. So if something today resonates with you, if something flicks your switch, if something encourages you, inspires you, motivates you today, would you let us know? I love to see the comments. I love to see the encouragement. And you know, it will just spur me on to keep preaching with everything I've got in the weeks and months to come. So today we're in a new series leading up to Easter called Reckless Love. And I wanted to recap our previous series, Anchored, because I believe that some of the truths that we looked at, some of the key thoughts that we discovered in that series, will really set us up nicely for this series, Reckless Love. So today, like I've already said, is all about Palm Sunday. So let's just read about it in Matthew 21 and verse 6. It says, "So the two disciples went on ahead and did as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and her colt to him and placed their cloaks and prayer shawls on the colt, and Jesus rode on it. Then an exceptionally large crowd gathered and carpeted the road before him with their cloaks and prayer shawls. Others cut down branches from trees to spread in his path. Jesus rode in the center of the procession, crowds going before him and crowds coming behind him, and they all shouted, 'Bring the victory, Lord, Son of David. He is the blessed one sent from the Lord Yahweh. We celebrate with praises to God in the highest.' As Jesus entered Jerusalem, the people went wild with excitement. The entire city was thrown into an uproar. Some asked, 'Who is this man?' And the crowd shouted back, 'This is Jesus. He's a prophet from Nazareth of Galilee.'" So everything about this event was celebratory. It was party time. There was a buzz. The atmosphere was definitely electric, like we were singing earlier. How could you not be excited about the fact that Jesus was riding into town? and the palm leaves that they took off the trees and laid out was their equivalent of rolling out a red carpet. And you know, this just brings up a point for us. With Jesus, there's always an excuse to party because there's always a reason to celebrate. Let me say that again. With Jesus, there's always an excuse to party because there's always a reason to celebrate. In fact, it says in Luke 19 and verse 39 that some Jewish religious leaders who stood off from the procession said to Jesus, "Teacher, order your followers at once to stop saying these things." Jesus responded, "Listen to me. If my followers were silenced, the very stones would break forth with praises." In other words, even if you silence the people, you can't stop the praise. Oh, I love that. Even if you silence the people, you can't stop the praise. The whole of creation is shouting God's praise. I love it. And if we're honest, we love this Palm Sunday story because it's full of the feel-good factor. It's uplifting, it's inspiring, it's motivating, it's everything that we want to see in Jesus. And on the surface, when we read about the kind of people that were in attendance, they all seem to be there for the right reason. And yet, because we know the end of the story, we know that most of those who had celebrated Jesus on Palm Sunday had abandoned him by Good Friday. Those who were shouting, "Bless him," on Palm Sunday were chanting, "Crucify him," not even a week later. What went wrong? Why was there this dramatic change so quickly in the minds and the hearts of people? Because they misunderstood why Jesus had come and who Jesus was. They were looking for someone to change their lives, to rescue them from the difficulties that they had experienced for too long. They wanted a Jesus who could change their natural circumstances, but they needed a Jesus who would transform their spiritual condition. He wasn't the Jesus they wanted, but he was the Jesus they needed. Let me say that again. He wasn't the Jesus they wanted, but he was the Jesus they needed. And consequently, they praised him when everything was feeling good, but then they cursed him when everything was looking bad. And to demonstrate what I'm saying, God in fact gave me a revelation. And it's so important that we understand this because it goes on in verse 41 of Luke 19. This is after Jesus had said, "You know what? If you silence the people, the very rocks will cry out." It says this, the next verse says this: "When Jesus caught sight of the city, he burst into tears with uncontrollable weeping over Jerusalem, saying, 'If only you could recognize that this day peace is within your reach, but you cannot see it.'" So why did Jesus weep uncontrollably? He had just witnessed adulation. Surely there was everything to be happy about. Surely this is what he lived for. But he wept because he could see and feel their rejection. He realized they didn't get it because he knew they couldn't see it. And here's the point. They didn't understand the only thing they needed saving from was themselves. The only thing they needed saving from was themselves. In fact, what God showed me here was that they had little or no knowledge of Jesus. They only wanted what he could do for them, not who he was to them. And this is another point for us to consider. We must always focus on who Jesus is to us, not what he can do for us. Let me say that again. We must always focus on who Jesus is to us, not what he can do for us. They couldn't see how much they needed a personal savior to rescue them from their sin. They thought Jesus would come merely to destroy their enemies and save them from their hardships. They wanted someone to fix it without having to faith it. They wanted a Jesus who could pull a rabbit out of the hat. Let's never wish for a Jesus who can pull rabbits magically out of hats when we have a Savior who miraculously came out of the grave. Let me say that again. Let's never wish for a Jesus who can pull rabbits magically out of hats when we have a Savior who miraculously came out of the grave. They wanted Jesus to give them an up life without any downs. But as we well know, life is always full of ups and downs. Because the power of Christianity is demonstrated when we're able to look up even though we're feeling down. Jesus showed us that suffering is part of life. Jesus showed us that even the Son of God doesn't escape suffering. And as I was praying about this, I could see how we still have the same problem today on Palm Sunday as they had back then on Palm Sunday. People still want a fix-it Jesus rather than a faith-it Jesus. And ultimately, he wants us and he wanted them to experience firsthand his reckless love. And to understand the word reckless, which doesn't mean what you think, by the way, we need to remember God's nature. God is not only loving, he's lavish. Let me tell someone over here. God is not only loving, he's lavish. And this is the time I want to introduce our key scripture for the series as we lead into Easter week. In Ephesians 1 and verse 3, it says, every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realm has already been lavished upon us as a love gift from our wonderful Heavenly Father, the Father of our Lord Jesus, all because he sees us wrapped into Christ. I want to just stop verse by verse here because this is a lot to take in. Every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realms has already been lavished upon us as a love gift from our wonderful Heavenly Father. You know, when we pray for more, we need to remember we already have it. We have a God who's lavished on us with every spiritual blessing. That means that when we pray to him and say more, what we're actually doing, or what we need to do, is pray, Lord, show us how to release what's already been lavished upon us. If it's already there, it's just a matter of releasing it. And it says he wanted to do this because he sees us wrapped in Christ. Wow, imagine being wrapped into Christ. Well, you are. Isn't that great news today? We are all wrapped into Christ. And this is why we celebrate him with all our hearts, it says. See, that's why he wept over the people, because he could see that they were celebrating him for completely different reasons. And what he wants us to do is to celebrate him for the right reason, to celebrate him. Why? Because we are wrapped into Christ. Why? Because he's lavished us with every spiritual blessing from the heavenly realm. Goes on to say, and in love he chose us before he laid the foundation of the universe. So long before Jesus did what he did for us, God had already chosen us. God had already chosen you. We are the chosen ones. He's chosen every single human being to be wrapped into Christ. Because of his great love, it says, he ordained us so that we would be seen as holy in his eyes with unstained innocence. Woo-hoo! Wow, can you just be impacted for a moment by those words? Because of his great love, he ordained us so that we would be seen as holy in his eyes with an unstained innocence. When God looks at you, he looks through the eyes of Jesus and he sees you as holy with an unstained innocence. That means everything you've done, past, present, and future, is not viewed because he sees you with an unstained innocence. Goes on to say, for it was always in his perfect plan to accept us as his delightful children through our union with Jesus, the Anointed One. Wow, let me just stop. I know that's halfway through a verse. It was always his intention. It was always his perfect plan to adopt you and I as his delightful children. He delights in us. He delights in us when we understand that he wanted to lavish us. And when we accept that love that he's lavished on us, it says he delights in the prosperity of his people. Goes on to say, through our union with Jesus, the Anointed One, so that his tremendous love that cascades, wow, cascades over us would glorify his grace. Let me just stop there. So look at that. Through our union with Jesus, so we have to have a union with Jesus, the Anointed One, so that his tremendous love that cascades over us. Imagine like when we see water cascading. It says that's what happens with his love. It cascades over us. And that will glorify his grace. In other words, it will tell the world just how much he loves us. Look what it goes on to say. For the same love he has for the beloved Jesus, he has for us. When I read that, that blew my mind. The same love that he had for his beloved Jesus, he has for us. He loves you in the same way that he loved Jesus. What did he do for Jesus? He did everything. What did he do for us? He did everything. Why? Because his nature is to do everything for his children. The same that he did for Jesus, the same he will do for us. He gave us everything through Jesus. Why? Because he did not hold back. He was not selfish in his approach. He was lavish, and he gave us everything that there was to be had. And it says, and this unfolding plan brings him great pleasure. So not only did he plan to do it, but it gives him great pleasure. Wow, I just love that key scripture, which we're going to read again next week as well, because it demonstrates what reckless love is truly all about. It's the overwhelming, never-ending, undeserving love of God that God didn't withhold from us, but gave to us freely through Jesus, who cost him dearly. This is what Jesus was weeping about. The fact that they had been offered this love and shown this grace, and instead of accepting it, they rejected it by looking for what he could do rather than who he was. Wow. And it's so true today. I believe Jesus weeps when so many reject his love that cost him. It cost God so much when he sent Jesus so freely. So as we close today, let me ask you this question. Do you know that love? Have you accepted that grace? Do you know the lavish nature of our Heavenly Father, who has blessed you with every spiritual blessing that there is in the heavenly realm? And all you've got to do is accept it. And all you've got to do is let it unfold in your life. If you've never accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, can I lead you in a prayer today to do so? Just say these words and say, Lord Jesus, I want to thank you for your lavish love, that you will not just love him, but you will lavish, that you have promised me that you have blessed me with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realm here on earth. So today I accept the love and the grace that you have shown towards me, and I give my life to you. And I thank you that that scripture said that when you look at me, you look through eyes that see an unstained innocence. Even though I know I'm undeserving, I am overwhelmed right now by the fact that you only see me through the eyes of Jesus. But Lord, I can't pray this prayer without saying sorry for all that I've done, for all that is in my past, but I want to thank you that when you look at me today, I believe you're saying to me, what past? Because you don't even remember it anymore, because through Jesus, you only see the best of me. You only see the rest of my life. And so today, I give my life to you. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer today, woohoo! Would you let us know? Let us know in the comments below, because we want to share with you. We want to rejoice with you. And if you want to tell a couple of people in a virtual prayer room what you've just done, then send an email to prayer@destinyuk.com, and Liz and Paul would love to hear from you, and they will be happy with you, partying with you, if you have prayed this prayer today. Maybe today you already know the love. You've already accepted the grace. But I wonder whether you've slipped into worshiping Jesus for what he can do for you rather than who he is to you. You know, sometimes in life, we have prayer lists that are endless. We come to God and we pray for the next need before we even thank him for the last breakthrough. And there's a danger that we treat God like, you know, a consumer, like we are just ready to keep taking from him. But today he wants us to give to him. What does he want us to give? He wants us to give our lives. He wants us to give back to him our lives in thankfulness and praise for what he did for us on the cross. But more than that, for who he is, for who he is in us, for who he is because he is a kind and loving God. He is a powerful God. He is a God that is able to touch our lives and change our lives in ways that no other thing or person could do. And that's why we don't just need a doing God. We need a God who is. That's why he said, I am, because that's the most important thing that we could ever, ever understand, that who he is I am. Wow. Come on, if you need prayer today because maybe you've slipped into this doing God, let me pray for you. Father, I pray, and I pray for myself, I pray for all those watching today, that maybe all of us in some way have slipped into a prayer pattern of asking you for what you can do and expecting you to always do something rather than just say thank you for who you are. Thank you that you are God Almighty. Thank you that we have you in our lives, watching over us, living in us. And we are so grateful. Lord, if you didn't do another thing, you've already done enough for the rocks to cry out in praise. And so today, we don't want to leave it to the rocks. We want to praise you for who you are, the great I am. Father, we thank you that the best is yet to come, that as we unfold this lavish nature, as we reveal more and more about your lavish nature, that we will stop asking you to do more, and we will just unfold more, and we will experience more because of doing that. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, if you prayed that prayer today, I would love to hear from you. If you need more prayer, jump in the prayer room with Paul and Liz, prayer@destinyuk.com. They'll send you an invite back. Whatever you're doing this week, let's be very mindful of what week it is. Wherever we are in the world, you know, it's the same week. It's Easter week, and we're going to celebrate next Sunday on Resurrection Sunday. And we're going to introduce a new song next week. It's a fabulous song, one that you really are going to find it very easy to worship to. And I can't wait to introduce that next week. But whatever you're doing this week, remember all the days leading up. You know, we have Maundy Thursday, we have Good Friday, and we have Resurrection Sunday. A lot went on that week, and a lot went on in between all that too. And we'll just be putting out things this week as reminders. And what a great week we are going to have, just celebrating Jesus. And so whatever you're doing, have a great week, and we'll see you next Sunday.
Awakes to give you all the praise.
Amen.